Hey everyone, I'm going to show you how to pass in different information to a storyline course just by adding something to a URL. My name is Jeff Batt with Learning Dojo, and let's go ahead and dive in here. If you head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja, and if you go to learningdojo.ninja/javascript-snippets, you can actually get these same files that I'm working with right here. This is all of my different JavaScript snippets that you can use, and you can check out all of my previous videos as well, covering each of these. And I'm just going to talk about one section for now. You can go ahead and download the project file. And the one that we're going to be talking about is actually 1.7 called query strings. Query strings allows you to append or add something to a URL. So if you have your course even inside of an LMS, or if you have it on a website or somewhere, you could actually add additional information that will get passed back into Storyline. And then with that information, it updates a variable so you can actually go down different pathways. You can take the learner down this pathway, or you could update states based on the variable amounts. It could be like the location of the learner or the time of year or something like that. So there's a lot of possibilities, and I'm just going to show you how to use it. If we head on over to the Storyline project file that was downloaded, we're going to go to 1.7. So whatever the title is here, that's the page that you go to. And inside of Storyline, I have two variables already set up to go. And in fact, any of these sections that you're looking at, the Storyline variables that are needed are over in blue on the right-hand side, and it lets you know what you need inside of your project there. And then you can just copy the code inside of some trigger. Now, I'm going to do this when the page loads. And so as soon as the page loads, it's going to look for the query string. It's going to look for information in the URL, and it's going to pull that in. I'm going to just add a trigger here, and this is going to be a custom JavaScript trigger. I'll scroll down to execute JavaScript here, and then I will pop open my JavaScript window. Now, from here, I can just copy in that code. Let's go ahead and hit paste here and click OK. Now, if I click OK here, this is going to update automatically as soon as this page loads. And that's where you can see right here when timeline starts. However, if I just preview this inside of Articulate Storyline, it's not going to do anything. It's not going to have any updated information because I'm not inside of a web browser and I have not added any additional things to my URL, to my address. So that's why we see nothing here and we just see NaN right there. Let's go ahead and publish this out. We do need to preview this inside of a browser. I'm just going to hit publish here. Now I'm going to click on view project. Here is the URL right there. So if I place this on a website, in fact, if I took this and I uploaded it to learningdojo.ninja, I could create a folder on my website and then I could say URL or something, or course one or something like that. And then it would be, from this point, it would be learningdojo.ninja/course101/story.html. Now on the back of this URL, that's where we put this information in order to pass in different things. Before we even get to that page, this line of code right here lets me know the type of information. And really we need this question mark and pass that. Now I could add on additional or change the variables of this if I wanted to, but I would just need to come in, and if I change this, for example, the name, I would just need to come in here and change this to be something else, or at least this part to be something else, and that part. So it basically correlates based on what you're doing. And I'll show you how to do that here in a second. But let's just grab this. I'm going to copy that, and then I'm going to add it to the end of that URL. So right after HTML, we can do question mark and then just hit enter. And I'm really not 20, for example. But if we come into the query string right here, notice how it now passes in that information, Jeff and 20. Let's go ahead and just replace where it says Jeff there. And I'm going to just say Sam, for example, and let's do the age of 38. And I'm going to hit resume, and you'll notice it now has Sam and 38. Based on that URL information, passes into a variable, and then based on that variable, I could take them down different pathways. Or I could change the state of some image to be based on a certain area. So hopefully you see the benefit of that. You do have to get to the URL specifically And if your LMS has like a direct link or something like that, you can just add this, append this, or add it to the end of that direct link, and it should work there as well. So that is how you get in and update that. But let's say we wanted to create a new one. Well, in order to do that, I'm going to go into Storyline, and I'm going to create a new variable called test variable. Let's just call this one test var. And we're going to keep this as a text. If it was a number where I'm going to add to it, I would change the number. But let's just go ahead and click OK. So we have that test var here. Now, inside of the JavaScript, or actually on the page, let's go ahead and just insert that text. I'm going to go insert a text box, or we can do it right here, actually. We can just write after, and then let's insert a reference, and we're going to do test var, our test variable here. Where is that at? There we go. So I'm going to double click, and there we go. All right, so that is in place. Now let's update the JavaScript. And in the JavaScript, what I need to do is, first of all, get the information. This is basically saying, hey, what are the URL values? We're going to get the URL, and then we're going to get the parameters. Parameters are anything that has like the question mark and past that. We're going to get all the parameters. And once we get all the parameters, we can then dive into specific parameters here. Now, we can call it whatever we want, but let's just say let test var equals, and that's how you create a variable. Now, we then do the same thing here. In fact, you can just copy that, paste it right there, and we're going to have test var in our URL. So I'll need to add the URL to that, and then I will need to go ahead and push it back to Storyline. We're going to push it back to the variable of test var. So we're creating a test var kind of locally. I've mentioned this in previous videos, but when you're working in Storyline, it's like having a separate window. You're kind of pulling the information, working with it, and then pushing it back to Storyline. Right now, we're pulling the information from the URL, and then we're pushing it back to Storyline. We're going to push this test var back right there. So now we need to add on to this. We need to say, okay, what is going to be this variable name? And in this case, we're looking for something called test var. So I just need to add an ampersand, and then I need to say test var, and there can be no spaces, just so you know. And then we put in the amount, or what the value is. And I'm just going to say sample. I'm going to pass in that variable. This could be first name, last name, location, whatever you want it to do, that's up to you. So I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And in order to preview this, I do need to, let me copy that URL just so I get it exactly. I'm going to copy this to the question mark right there. Click OK. Let's go ahead and just hit publish and then publish this out. Now, this is how you actually work with xAPI. And if you're passing in information, it actually uses query strings. There's other ways, and I've talked about this, other ways to capture who the person is through the LMS. But if you're putting this on a course, like on a URL, and you wanted to do xAPI, you would need to use query strings in order to have the course know about who the user is and so forth. Let's go ahead and click on View Project. We're going to add this to the end of the URL, hit enter, and then go to query string. Oh, I have it misspelled there. So let's say test var and not text var. Let's go ahead and just make sure that is all updated. Yep. So it needs to be all the same, test var, there we go. And now it should work. Let's go ahead and republish this. All right, so we click on View Project, and now let's go ahead and paste that in test var, hit enter, and then go to query strings, and there we go. So that is how you use query strings inside of Articulate Storyline 360. You can pass in this information. You could pass in different content. This is a way to kind of randomize the course, so you could give somebody one URL, somebody else another URL, and pass in different information and have the course function differently based on the variable amount as well. Hopefully this has been helpful for you and you see some application for this. If you want to check out more, you can head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja. You can check out all previous blog posts where I cover everything learning development related. You can also download free templates in Articulate Storyline 360, xAPI and video templates, and check out full courses. If any of this is new to you, you can check out full courses in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. My goal for this channel is to help you become the best learning developer that you can be, giving you tips and tricks to get the most out of your e-learning tools. If you have any comments or if you have any suggestions, head on over to this video on YouTube and then leave a comment down below. I check those comments every single week. And if you have any other suggestions of or what you're trying to do, feel free to type those below and I will either add it to my blog list, my backlog, or I can help you out in the best way that I can there. And while you're there on YouTube, make sure that you click the like button and subscribe to my channel and hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows my channel to grow, and allows me to continue to produce these videos for you. Well, that's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.